Let's start the last topic for this session. In this third topic for the session, we'll be covering the last technique of risk and uncertainty in capital budgeting, that is decision tree analysis. Decision tree is the most widely used method today when you talk about risk analysis. The decision tree actually keep NPV as a base when you do it, but in decision tree, what do? We assign probabilities. We assign probabilities and then we take it forward how NPV has to be taken into consideration for risk and analysis. Now, I'll give you a small example about how decision tree is actually practically used. Now, keep NPV as a base and use probabilities as well. Now, there's a risk in the future as well, and we're trying to tackle the risk by using certain methods over here, right? And sometimes risky and complex decisions require that you should be very confident today when you're making that investment as such, and all your events about the future are assigned with probability. Now, for example, I'll give you a small example how decision tree is practically done. For example, I have a project A, right? Now, let's start with one project and I'll start tell you how to compare it as well. Now, project A, I assume first year profit maybe, I'll give it very simple, 1000, 2000 and 3000. I'm assuming. Now, I'm just assuming first year may give me a profit of 1000 or 2000 or 3000. Now, if I get 1000 profit in first year, see, I'm just telling, I may get a profit of 1, 2 or 3. If I get a profit of 1000 in first year, then second year how much I'll get? I may get a profit of again 1000, 2000 or 3000. If again I get a profit of 2000 in first year, second year might be 1000, 2000 or 3000. If first year I get a profit of 3000, second year profit may be 1000, 2000 or 3000. Now, what do we do? There's certain so many things can happen. If I say I'll get a profit of 1000 in first year, I cannot be so confident about it, right? It'll either be 1000, 2000 or 3000. Similarly, second year accordingly it goes on. So, what do we do up for a person? We assign probabilities first. What is the probability you get a profit of 1000, 2000 or 3000 in first year? So, you may not get all the three profits. You may either get 1000, 2000 or 3000. If I tell you all the three profits have equal probability. Equal probability means that each will have a probability of 0.33, 0.33, 0.33. Go to second year. Again, I said they'll have equal probability, 0.3, 0.3, 0.3. Do NPV as you normally do. Multiply your cash inflows with the probabilities. Then you find out the total cash inflows and then you use a discounting factor. So many things can happen. And to make it more easy for us, what do? We make a decision tree for it. For example, if two projects are there, project A and project B, first year certain sets of profit, second year certain sets of profit under the first head. So we make a decision tree for simplicity purpose and we start assigning probabilities and then you do NPV as you normally do NPV at the end. Right? Higher NPV we accept, lower NPV we reject at the end. And that is how it is done. Now, remember certainty coefficient factor, what you did, cash inflows into certainty factor into discounting factor. Over here what we'll do, cash inflows into probability into discounting factor will give you NP, will give you present value of cash inflow, then you continue NPV as you normally do. So make it more simple by designing a decision tree and then you decide whether to accept or reject a project. But constructing a decision tree involves various steps. For example, first you need to define your problem, then evaluate different alternatives. Okay, first year I may get 1000, 2000, 3000 profit. If I get 1000 in first year, second year again I have this much profits. Then what do you do? Start indicating that decision points. Maybe the decision needs to be made. Decision needs to be made at first year, second year, third year profit. Then second year, which is a decision point for me? Then you start analyzing the probability. Now, assign the probabilities for all of them. So you may not get all the three profits. Certain probabilities will occur, multiply the inflows with the probability. Then you analyze the alternatives. In whichever case NPV is the highest, that will go for as such. So if you have two, three projects, make a decision tree and take it forward. Decision tree involves a lot of steps in short, and that's it's a complete method which takes into account the other methods of risk analysis, that is the probability. It takes NPV as a base as well. And that is how a decision tree is constructed.